The following simulation model explains how to evaluate the area of the given region under the given curve and above the x-axis. Now we are going to evaluate the area of the region under the line and above the x-axis. To evaluate the area under the region, we normally construct rectangles of equal width. In this region, we have 5 rectangles. When you have 5 rectangles, the width of each rectangle is 200 units. But here, look at this, the actual area of the given region is 450 square units. Whereas under this construction, the calculated area is simply 380, much less than the actual value, because here the small white triangles we did not consider. In our calculation, these areas are not considered. Therefore, the calculated area is much less than the actual area. Suppose let us increase the number of rectangles. Look at this. When we increase the number of rectangles, the width of the rectangle is reduced. At the same time, the calculated area is coming closer and closer to the actual area. So we go on, increase the number of rectangles. Look at this. The calculated area is coming very close to the actual area. Look at this. It's coming closer. Yes, we have covered the whole area. Now the width of the rectangle is almost 1 unit. Each rectangle becomes a straight line. In this case, what happened? The whole area is covered and the calculated area is very, very close to the actual area. Let us consider another example. Let us consider decreasing function. In the decreasing function, if you want to calculate the area of the region under the given straight line, as usual, we construct rectangles. We have constructed 5 rectangles. The length of each rectangle is 200 units. But look at the answer. Actual area is 450 square units. Whereas here the calculated area is 520 square units. Why it is so? Because here we have added the extra regions. These regions are not included in the actual area. Therefore, it is more. Now, as usual, we go on, increase the number of rectangles. When we increase the number of rectangles, the width of the rectangle is reduced. Look at this. Now, we are increasing the number of rectangles. The width is also reduced. Same time, the calculated area is coming closer to the actual area. Still we increase. Now when we increase, what happened now? Yes, see here. Now the width is 6 here. When the width of the rectangle is 6 units, we have this much area. When we reduce the width, we have reduced the width to almost 1 unit. The calculated area is 450.3 square units. That is 0.3 square units more than the actual area. Let us consider the semicircle, another example of semicircle. In this case, look at this, the error function is more. See here, the percentage of error is almost 170. Let us go on, decrease the width of each rectangle. That means we have to increase the number of rectangles. Let us increase the number of rectangles. We go on, increase the number of rectangles. So look at this, the area, the calculated area is coming very close to the actual area. Yes, now this is the best approximate calculated area, which is almost same as the actual area. The difference is just 0.1 square unit. Let's consider a polynomial. This is a polynomial. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rectangles, and in this polynomial we have not included these white triangle areas, included this extra area, this extra area. Therefore the difference is more now. Difference is more. Actual area is 7,325.5 square unit, but here the calculated area is much less, that is 5,800 square units, because we have not calculated these white shaded areas. Now let us increase the number of rectangles. At the same time, the width of the rectangle will be reduced. Look at this. Now the calculated area is coming closer to the actual area. Let us see the error function. Percentage of error is almost 90 plus. Now still we go on, increase the number of rectangles. Look at the error function. It comes to 58%. We increase the number of rectangles. Yes, we go on increasing. Now the value is coming closer. What's the error function? Error function is, even now it is around 35%. Still is there, so we have to increase. Let us increase the number of rectangles. Yes, yes, yes. It's coming closer, closer, closer. Yes! This is the best approximate calculated area. The difference is just 0.2 square units. Let us go for horizontal line. We have only 5 rectangles. What is the actual area? 70 square units. What's the calculated area? 70 square units. Why it is so? Because we have not included any extra area, and we have not excluded any of the area to be calculated. Therefore, it is exact. Now increase the number of rectangles. Look at this, there's no change. There's no change here. The reason is, here everything is exactly the rectangle shape. None of the area is left over, or none of the area is included which are not included in the actual calculated area. This says about how to evaluate integral. Therefore, in the process of integration, we take limit n tends to infinity. What do you mean by let n tends to infinity? N is the number of rectangles. The number of rectangles must be more and more, almost close to infinite number, so that none of the area is left over. This is how we calculate.